Hi, in this video I'm going to show you valve clearances adjustment for Honda R-Series engines according to service and repair manual. This is an 8th generation Honda Civic with 1.8 liter engine, but this step-by-step guide is also suitable for other Honda models listed below the video. Adjust the valves only when the engine temperature is less than 38 degrees Celsius. Maintenance schedule and complete list of special tools and spare parts you can find below in the description of the video. Using 10 mm wrench, loosen the nut and disconnect the negative terminal from the battery. Remove decorative wiring harness cover using slotted screwdriver, rotating studs 90 degrees counterclockwise. Using 10 mm socket with ratchet and extension, remove two bolts securing front wiring harness holder. Disconnect four ignition coil connectors. Using the same 10 mm socket with ratchet and extension, remove four nuts securing the ignition coils. Remove the ignition coils and cover ignition coils mounting holes using a clean cloth in order to avoid getting any dirt. I used plastic wrap for this purpose. Slide the rubber cover and remove the terminal nut using 10 mm socket with ratchet and extension, and disconnect the terminal itself. Slide the rubber cover and disconnect the alternator connector by pressing the clip. Disconnect the air conditioning compressor clutch connector and remove the wiring harness clamp moving clip to the left. Remove the front wiring harness holder from the bracket, sliding it to the right. Move the front wiring harness aside. Then remove two bolts securing second wiring harness holder using 10 mm socket with ratchet extension and also universal joint, since it's difficult to access these bolts. To have an access to all cylinder head cover bolts, remove the injector cover, which is secured by three clips. Be careful, don't loose the rubber bushes while removing clips, and release the wiring harness from the holder located on the right side of the cover. Now it's time to remove eight bolts securing the cylinder head cover located around its perimeter. Using 10 mm socket with ratchet and extension, remove four bolts. To have an access to the remaining four, it's required in addition to use universal joint. Using pliers, loosen the clamp of crankcase ventilation system hose and slide it to the right. Then remove the hose itself. Remove the oil dipstick. Remove the cylinder head cover with the gasket, carefully lifting it off. For the vehicles with manual transmission, put the gear lever in neutral position. For the automatic transmission, put the selector lever either in park or neutral. Before the adjustment, using a clean cloth, wipe the top edge of the cylinder head around the perimeter. Cylinders are numbered from left to right, starting from the timing chain. Before adjustment, set the first cylinder piston at the top dead center. To do this, remove the front right wheel or turn the steering wheel all the way to the right, and then find the crankshaft pulley bolt, which is located behind the wheel arch liner. Using 19mm socket, ratchet and extension, rotate the crankshaft clockwise so that the up mark on the camshaft sprocket would be at the top, and the top dead center grooves on the camshaft sprocket should line up with the top edge of the head. You can check the accuracy of setting the piston at the top dead center using filler gauge. To check and adjust two exhaust valves of the first cylinder, use 0.25mm thickness filler gauge. For intake valves, use 0.2mm thickness filler gauge. The variation of the clearances could be in the range of 0.02mm. Insert 0.2mm thickness filler gauge between the adjusting screw and the end of the intake valve stem and slide it back and forth. You should feel a slight amount of drag. Similarly, check the second intake valve of the first cylinder. In my case, the clearance exceeds the required limit. This can be seen using 0.25mm thickness filler gauge, which slides as well, but with a slight amount of drag. Adjustment is required. Using 10mm socket with a ratchet, loosen the lock nut and with small slotted screwdriver or slotted bit socket, because the space is limited and a simple slotted screwdriver is difficult to use, rotate the adjusting screw until the drag on the filler gauge would be correct. Now it's necessary to lock the adjusting screw in required position. To do this, slightly tighten the lock nut using 10mm ring wrench and holding the adjusting screw at the same time. Finally, tighten the lock nut with the torque wrench to 14 Nm. Similarly, check and if necessary adjust the second intake valve clearance. Then, check the clearance of the exhaust valves of the first cylinder using 0.25mm thickness filler gauge. In my case, again, the filler gauge slides without any drag. Adjustment is performed similarly for exhaust valves. The only difference is that the adjustment screw can be rotated with a simple slotted screwdriver. After adjustment, slightly tighten the lock nut using 10mm ring wrench and holding the adjusting screw at the same time. And then tighten the lock nut with the torque wrench to 14 Nm. Similarly, check and if necessary adjust the second exhaust valve clearance. Further adjustment is performed in the firing order of cylinders for this engine. First, third, fourth, second. Rotate the crankshaft clockwise to set the third cylinder piston at the top dead center. Align the piston top dead center groove on the camshaft sprocket with the top edge of the cylinder head. Similarly, check and if necessary adjust the clearances of two exhaust valves and two intake valves of the third cylinder. Repeat the procedure for the valves of the fourth cylinder. and then do all the same for the valves of the second cylinder. After adjustment, rotate the crankshaft so that the camshaft sprocket performs two complete turns, and recheck all the clearances and, if necessary, adjust them. Recheck the tightening of all lock nuts again with the torque wrench. Adjustment finished. Now remove old cylinder head cover gasket and thoroughly clean its groove using slotted screwdriver wrapped with a clean cloth. Install new cylinder head cover gasket in the groove. Remove oiled residue sealant from the oil pump housing and cylinder head mating areas. I used slotted screwdriver for this purpose. Wipe the top edge of the cylinder head around the perimeter using a clean cloth. Apply high temperature sealant on the oil pump housing and cylinder head mating areas. It's important that the sealant must be specifically designed for such surfaces. If 5 minutes or more have passed after applying the sealant, do not install cylinder head cover. Instead, remove the old residue and reapply the sealant. Install the cylinder head cover. Tighten the bolts in 2 or 3 steps in the prescribed sequence. I tightened in 2 steps, at first slightly, using 10mm socket with a ratchet. And then finally tightened all bolts in sequence to 9.8 Nm using torque wrench. Installation is the reverse order of removal. Insert the oil dipstick all the way back. Install the injector cover and reconnect the wiring harness to the holder. Install crankcase ventilation system hose and slide the clamp. Install the second wiring harness holder and tighten 2 bolts to 9.8 Nm. Install the front wiring harness holder to the bracket. Install the wiring harness clamp. connect the air conditioning compressor clutch connector, the alternator connector, and the terminal. Tighten two bolts securing the front wiring harness holder to 9.8 Newton meters. Install the ignition coils and tighten nuts to 12 Newton meters. Install ignition coil connectors. Install decorative wiring harness cover, rotating studs 90 degrees clockwise. Install front right wheel. Connect the negative battery terminal and tighten the nut. Complete it. Don't run the engine for at least 3 hours after installing cylinder head cover in order to allow the sealant to harden. Also refer to the instructions for use of a particular type of sealant. Thank you for watching. Hope you find this video helpful.